10,000 years ago, before the birth of Christ, before the time of recorded history, and after the collapse of the mighty Atlantean civilizations, there began all those antique landscapes, the age of the Hyborian gods, Crom, Mitra, Terim, Erdic, Ishtar. From Elysium, then, Mitra peered into the primordial mists, harbinger of floods and pestilence and vile fevers and unspeakable acts of barbarism. Mitra spoke, "Forge me an instrument of retribution. I wish to prophesy through the rage of the naked sword." A solitary voice responded, the throaty retort of Erdic, the dark god. It shall be done. From below, purple flames etched the form of a woman, a singular woman, doomed to aloneness and cursed with beauty enough to drive legions of men to madness. The most magnificent vessel of wrath, heir to stalk the ancient kingdoms, prioress of the apocalypse, deaconess of perversity, with a body that amplitude enough to drive 10,000 men to madness. The penultimate woman with hair of crimson. Well, the plundering hordes of Yezdegerd, scourge of Virginia, hammered on the doors of thrice doomed Macleth. She was there when Tengor, conqueror of the East, set the night ablaze in black Kitai and built a pagan temple from the skulls of its fallen foes. She was there. And when the black specter of the world, devouring Tulan, loomed dark over the Hyborian realm, I perhaps shall be there then. As well. And here as well. For with the practice of necromancy, the darkest of arts, I, Thenef the Wizard, will bring Red Sonja to this city of concrete and steel beside this mighty ocean. Steel for steel, then, flesh for flesh, bone and sinew manifest.
Tis I, Thenef the Wizard.
Wizard, eh? Something tells me that's not the wine of wisdom I detect on your breath.
The corporeal body, indeed. My necromancy has succeeded. Also, the wit is present. But there is a doubt as to whether this is the bona fide Red Sonja. A bit of interrogation is necessary to ascertain whether we have, in fact, the Red Sonja. In the whispered legends of Red Sonja, if need be Red Sonja, there was an adventure that you had with a unicorn. I believe As part of that, there was an evil plot by a priest whose body was all tattooed over with strange configurations. Do you recall the name of that evil priest?
Aye, the black-hearted dog, one who deserved to die. Andara Bisparda, may he rot in hell.
May he rot in hell, indeed, yes. That is correct. That is correct. One more. In the Chronicles of Red Sonja, it was said that she traveled to the far distant lands of Athos and Zotos. And the queen of Athos was said to have possessed the strange power to transform her human form to that of a venomous spider. Do you recall her name?
She whom I did beat roundly that day, 'twas Sortilege.
Sortilege, indeed. Then we do have the Red Sonja. The Red Sonja. Now, Sonja, I'm just a bit curious. If we do have Sonja here, just, what was it that you promised Conan the Sumerian in return for his helping you in the sack of Shadazar?
You lecherous old sot. You dare ask such a question? By all the gods, wizard, you go too far. You have meddled in things beyond your kin, and now you must pay the price. Carrion eater, jackal's breath, nightmare conjurer, fool! Stand to, you babbling father of toads.
Red Sonja, the sword from her day is at root, without motion, and totally in the control of Feneth the wizard. If only the clone wizard Clayton were here to see how well I had done my most magnificent trick. Yes, Red Sonja, a banquet of womanhood, totally in control of Feneth the wizard. Red Sonja's mine. Mine.
Sonja. Not bad, old wizard. I've tangled with clumsier sorcerers than you. Come on, let's have a swig of whatever it is you've been guzzling all day. All this hugger-mugger gives me a thirst. Whew! That's not bad either. If I get tired drinking it, I can always use it to scour the rust off my sword. You know something? I like you, Thenneth. I'll even answer the last question you asked me. What was it I promised Conan the Sumerian? Something neither he nor any other arrogant oaf shall have. Myself. Let them pursue me if they want. By Erlich, there isn't a man living who won't make a bigger ass of himself than the piece he's after.
Well, what do you expect, Red Sonja? I mean, you are a beautiful woman.
From men, I expect the worst.
The worst being that they expect you to act like a woman.
Who are you? Who is any man to say how a woman must carry herself through life? When this world was created, was any law ever set down dictating that men must be strong and hard, while women must be soft and weak?
Some have been so presumptuous to assume so.
Then they are fools! Mitra's mother herself would curse such a mandate.
What an honor to be in the presence of someone who can speak the gods.
Early blast your backside, wizard. You've a tongue as sharp as a thorn.
And you, my warrior maid, have a wit as sharp as your blade.
Think so? Well, perhaps you're right. Though I don't see what use there is in the sharpest wit. When laughter only leaves a bitter taste in the mouth. I'll tell you this, wizard. It's a grim world at best. I've been in many battles. I've taken many wounds. And I bear the scars to prove it. But at least no one can say this warrior hasn't doled out better than she's been dealt so far. The poor son of a she-dog who gave me this one no longer has a sword arm. Right or left. Terran's blood, but it's been a good life. My father used to say, keep to the house, girl. Wield a cooking pot and leave conquer. It's not solely a man's prerogative, you know. A woman can feel it too, just as deeply. The gods know I'd burst from within if I could not give vent to my rage. A woman's rage, born of a time when I was too weak to defend myself, to strike back, and so lost everything. One thing I know, and I know it only too well. A woman is vulnerable unless she knows how to use a sword. Then the odds are evened up a bit. May Mithra strike me blind if that is not so. No man shall have Red Sonja, save he that first bests me in battle. I swore that oath in another lifetime, it seems. Have I denied my sex? Am I a shapeless, soulless thing, clinging to a surrogate manhood for the sake of a vow that no longer has meaning? Oh, it's stupid to question. A warrior shouldn't think too much anyway. After all, it isn't a bad life as living goes. You spill a little blood, drink your fill of ale, then spend the rest of your time trading tall tales in the dark of some smelly tavern with your comrades. What brains are needed for that? No. Best not to think, but live like a wild animal with claws bared and instinct and cunning sharper than mere thought. Aye, that is the way to survive in this world. The meek, the soft-hearted have no chance, more's the pity. I would that were not so. I were not what I am. But forged was I, as surely as this blade I hold. And fate was the smith who tempered me in flame. There are friends awaiting me in hell. I hear their call.
Sonja.
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 Damn to you, demons and devils. I'll greet you in the pit soon enough. What do you want?
Foolish frail mortals.
Did you could defy the Dark Ones forever?
We seek a prize that has escaped us once too often.
We seek your soul, Red Sonja of Hyrcania.
Strike with your pitiful sword. Wonderfully done, Sonja. A time for celebration. A bit more magic. The technique of celestial imagery is rather elementary. Allow me to reward you, Sonja, with a brief vision of your Herculean homeland. In celestial imagery of your motherland, the molten spires beyond the sea of Iliad, Sonja. The fields will be in view, Sonja. The vale, Sonja, indeed. The trees, the snowy peaks, the burning slopes, the majestic Herculia, Sonja.
Watch out for the blinding flash! The whole storm!
It looks like you're here for the con.
What? I Red Sonja to rub elbows with these dogs, these knaves, these varlets? By Erlich, I think I'm going to feel right at home. To your health then, sword brothers, and may Erlich blast us all!
Hail Red Sonja!
Thank you.